What God cannot do does not exist. What my God cannot do does not exist. I almost had miscarriage. I was bleeding while I was pregnant. Devil did not stop. My EDD was December. When he was planning, God was planning something different for me. They had to rush me. They called an ambulance, took me straight to the hospital. They checked, did a scan, checked the babies. The doctor was like, "We've been scanning you ever since all along, that the babies, they've been fine. How come all of a sudden one of the babies have water in her rib cage, in her ribs, and the stomach?" There were too many things back to back, too many attacks back to back. But I remained on the prayer altar. I remained on the prayer altar. The babies even know the voice of the prayer, because anytime I'm praying, I keep the phone close to the stomach. Let them hear, let them know the voice. They rushed me in for CS just to take out the babies. Took out the babies. One of the babies was in ICU. They had to discharge me because I kept on bombarding them with Nsppd prayer on my phone. I went to the place where my child is. Lifeless. The doctors said one out of how many numbers usually survive this. They called it, the devil then was given a name, eye drop, and I told them that one is my own, not on my watch. I had to go and drop every morning, even I'll go and drop the phone beside her where she was put in an incubator. I kept on keeping that phone. This thing is not in Nigeria. Oh. These are foreign doctors. They had to invite a specialist down. All the doctors said the child cannot survive. Before the man came, that morning was the last Sunday of November. I slept on Saturday. I had a dream that a dog was trying to pick my child. When the dog would jump in and back, I would jump in the middle. The dog would shake back. When the dog will shift back, now we go out. When the dog tries to jump in again, I will jump into the middle. So early morning, Sunday morning, I woke up after that dream. I was like, what kind of dream is this? I started praying. That early morning, Pastor Jerry mentioned, I think second service, he said every mother that is worried over their children, over their child, that thing you are worried about will not happen. That every mother that is worried about their child should go on their knees. Before I even finished, go on your knees. I went on my knees, not on my watch.
If you are under the sound of my voice and your child or your children have any issue at all that bothers you, the Lord said to me last night, in my place of prayer, in this service, I will roll away reproaches from the lives of their children. If there is anything about your children that bothers you, get on your knees wherever you are. Let God be true and every man a liar. Every reproach against your children, whatever you remember, and it saddens your heart at the sound of your amen, I announce, let it be rolled away by fire. Let it be rolled away by fire.
Immediately, I went straight to my child, where the child was. I kept the phone close to the child. I was praying. The Indian doctors were like, that the child wasn't going to survive, even to the extent of going on his knees, squatting to tell me, because he was trying to convince me every day, like talked into my head, that the child wasn't going to survive. But I told my God that my child will survive. You know, that very day, I went there to see my child, and they brought the new X-ray. The doctor came in again at the same time when I went in, brought in the new X-ray. Pastor Jerry, it was like magic. They bore hole here on one side of the child, bore hole on the other side to drill out fluid because the lungs was already shrinking. They bore, put a tube, the tube that they put on two sides, put a tube on through the navel because they didn't want to open anywhere, through the navel to drill out fluid. I saw before and after of my child's X-ray, water dried up automatically from both sides. Water dried up in the stomach, but they still left the tube. They said they are watching her, that she has to be fine completely before they release her from it. My child came back home that December to do Christmas with me, with her sister, Pastor Jerry. In short, what God cannot do does not exist. What my God cannot do, what Jehovah God, what Jesus cannot do, does not exist. I have come to give glory to God for blessing me with wonderful twins. Both of them came back home safe and sound, strong and healthy, feeding well. All I've come to say is thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Pastor Jerry. Thank you, Pastor Oko. Thank you, Pastor Reno. Thank you, all the NSPDians. May God continue to bless us in this revival. We will win. Surely we will win. In Jesus' name. Amen. What God cannot do does not exist.